Hello, my name is Jack Hall, and I'm here to talk about making water droplet photographs. I'm on a cruise, and I'm actually videoing this in the bathroom because that's the place with the best light, and it's also the best place for sound as well, because even though there is a little bit of echo, I'm closer to the camera. So anyway, here we are on this cruise in the middle of the South Pacific, and it's multiple days between ports, and I was looking for something to do, and I got to thinking, well, you know, I think I may be able to do water droplets. So I was talking with my friends about it. We have a group that meets every morning at breakfast. Here's a shot of the group. And this is Bernie, saw the photos and said, well, why don't you make a video? And Richard, said, yeah, you need to make a video. Show us all how to do this. And so this is that video. My original pictures were just drops into a pool of water in the bathroom sink. And that's what those looked like. Then I decided I wanted to add some color to it. I've done it at home, and this is a copy of a picture that I took at home with much more elaborate equipment. So I decided after a few clear water shots that it would be nice to have a filtered flash. So I went and I got a wine bottle and I put that in front of the flash. And that made the pictures a little more interesting. A day later, we had blue goblets at one of our dinners. And I thought, that would make a great filter. So I got a blue goblet as well. So originally, I did just a pool of water in the sink. Then I decided, let's put it into a glass because you can be more precise in terms of your focusing. So I used a towel to help level the glass in the sink and then took a few photos. I was on, my camera settings were F8 at ISO 200. The flash was way too powerful. I am at -1/3 on the flash. And so these are some copies of the photos that I took in the sink. There were problems with focusing, mainly because I couldn't get my camera right at the same exact spot every time. I do have a tripod, but it was kind of awkward. So I thought, well, maybe if I move it to the tub. And so I moved to the tub, and initially I tried using my toothbrush for a focus. Here's a copy of that photo. That wasn't too good, and I thought, hey, if I have a fixed distance between the camera and where the water drop hits, then I can transfer that distance to the tub and it should be perfectly in focus. So on the counter of the bathroom sink, I set up two water glasses, one of them back in the corner, the other one exactly two chopsticks lengths away since I didn't have a ruler. I then put the back of the camera exactly halfway on the one glass that I was using as my tripod, and I put an ibuprofen pill on the other one, and I focused carefully on that. Now I've got my fixed focus. So I then took the two glasses, put them in the bathtub, and set them up two chopsticks apart. One was upright. The problem was the water was falling too close to the tub. So I modified that by taking one of the chopsticks and rubber banding it to the underside of the faucet so that the water would drip onto the chopstick, roll out to the end, drop, and go into the glass. I reset everything and then started taking photos. And I had some pretty good luck. So that's really just about all that I have to say about that. Aside from the fact that I hope you enjoy it, and I hope you go out and make your own water drop photos. Thank you.
¿Qué hacen aquí estas gaviotas, tan lejos del mar? ¿Qué hacen aquí, entre piedras y rincón, en este río marrón? ¿Qué hacen aquí, tan lejos del mar? ¿Qué hacen aquí estos pequeños, lejos del hogar? ¿Qué hacen aquí, entre piedras?